if, like me, you've watched a loved one suffer from dementia, you'll know how cruel and painful it is to see that person slip away from you right in front of your very eyes. Mm. Well, our first guest today knows all too well how it feels. She lost her husband to the illness after nursing him for the last 5 years of his life and has somehow found the strength to play a character who's suffering from the illness in Call the Midwife. Please welcome Judy Parfitt. Joining us today, and like I said, I watched my mother suffer with dementia, and it's such a hard illness. I think mainly for the people around, the one that's suffering from it. When was the first time? Because people always say this to me. When was the first time you noticed anything was wrong with your lovely husband?
Well, I think it's so insidious that you don't really notice at the beginning. It's little things that you just dismiss and think, oh, well, he's getting older. He was older than myself. Mm. And you just think, oh, that's nothing. And then I remember we had a meeting with our accountant, and my husband suddenly started out of the blue talking about something that was completely nonsense. Mm. And that's when it was like a little bomb going off in your stomach. You thought, this is not right. And then he would drive the car and decide not to stop at a roundabout. No. Thought he'd go straight over a roundabout. So that was hard because he adored his car, getting him to stop
driving. And did he know as well? Did he ever say to you, there's something not
right? I had to say, stop. But the reason I want to talk about it is because Dementia UK are doing Time for a Cuppa starting next week to raise money for dementia and Admiral nurses. Mm. Now, we all know that cancer people have Macmillan nurses, and the dementia people have 162 Admiral nurses.
For the whole country?
For the whole country. That's and I can only tell you that having looked after someone like that, people get very nervous with people with dementia because they don't know how to respond. Mm. I understand it's very difficult. So when he was ill, I had nobody, and I had a couple of carers came to turn him over and bathe him towards the end. And I stood at the end of the bed, and they talked over him as though he was a piece of meat.
Wow.
And fortunately, I had a friend who was a nurse, and I phoned up and told her, and she said, send them packing. And she came, thank God, and was wonderful because she knew and loved him. Now, if there'd been an Admiral nurse there, she would have known how to handle him, she would have known how to handle me, because it's very isolating.
Mm.
Because, as I say, people stay away.
Yes, I noticed that.
Because they're frightened. I had wonderful friends and neighbours who did know how to deal with it. Mm-hmm. But basically, they sort of cross the other side of the road because they don't know,
but
they're embarrassed.
So many people now have been diagnosed with dementia in the UK. I mean, the figure is, over 800,000.
Yes. Yeah.
So if there are only 162 of these nurses, the reason to raise the money to provide more is so
pressing. Well, it's not a sexy disease, is it? So it doesn't get the attention it should get. Mm. And it would be such a wonderful thing if we could raise more money to provide.
Thank you. Would you like to explain how the Cuppa moments work?
Yes. Now, next week, Dementia UK have got this idea of people can have like a coffee morning. Instead of going out with girlfriends and sitting in a crowded cave, you can do it at home and just do like fairy cakes or biscuits or whatever you want for a cup of tea. And they have this whole thing. You can get on their website and they'll let you know how to do it. You can get the package from them or whatever you want to do and help to raise money and have fun with your girlfriends and having cake
in the
and
process.
Tea.